प्रोफेसर पानमूर्ति, अदर फेलो पैनलिस्ट, डियर फ्रेंड्स, देयर इज नथिंग लेफ्ट फॉर मी टू डिस्कस. वी हैड अ गुड प्रेजेंटेशन इन द बिगिनिंग बाय पानमूर्ति, प्रोफेसर पानमूर्ति, एंड एन एक्सॉस्टिव डिस्कशन डन बाय डॉक्टर देवी प्रसाद. बट आई विल शेयर some important views by taking 10 minutes maximum. My first worry is, can we call this process as demonetization? And if it is a withdrawal of currency from circulation and replacing it by a new one, normally this is called demonetization. That has not happened in India. Of course, 1,000 rupee note is withdrawn from circulation permanently. And hence you may be compelled to say that this is a kind of partial demonetization or a different variant of demonetization. However, I am not competent to say that. Professor Panmurthy may be very competent to discuss on that topic. I hope that he will discuss in later. Then coming to the historical evidences of the success of the demonetization that took place elsewhere, we don't have a happy note. A practiced in demonetization was done by Soviet Union, Nigeria, Zimbabwe, Australia, then America. A number of countries had earlier practiced this demonetization. And America was a corrupt society, normally Richard Nixon, then President of America, announced the demonetization. There we witnessed some positive results. But in Soviet Union, what we witnessed is the fall of the country itself. And Nigeria, they have created a lot of problems. Though they are transformed to a cashless economy, partially, I don't say that fully they have transformed into Nigerian a cashless economy or a digital economy. But you are getting good stories from Nigeria in relation to the cashless economy. Okay, so you have no clear historical evidences to argue that demonetization will be a success strategy everywhere. You have a mixed feeling. We are hoping for the best in India. Then another important point I would like to submit before you is there any theoretical backup for the demonetization? Any theoretical framework? Well, you can talk in terms of the contribution made by monetarism or in terms of the Keynesian school of thought, etc., etc. They all considered money as an important variable, particularly the monetarist school. But there is an important theory called the modern monetary theory, which is actually the theoretical backup of this demonetization. What does this modern monetary theory say? It is argued that modern economies are working with fiat currencies, paper currencies, where the paper currency is not backed by any reserves. Only a negligible portion of the total currency issued by the government of India is backed by foreign reserves or gold. So, definitely when you withdraw the currency which is based on the fiat money, the government will not be in trouble only the people will be in trouble. That is an interesting story of the modern monetary theory. So here in India, that is proved. People are suffering a lot for the last more than 32 days. I continue with my previous stand that this is a bold and welcome step. No doubt. I continue with my stand. This is a bold and welcome step. But at the same time, I have the argument that on the implementation part, the government committed a lot of mistakes. But I don't have the fear to even say that. Conceptually also it is slightly flawed. In the sense that they have withdrawn 1,000 rupee notes and 500 rupee notes from circulation and replaced by 2,000 rupee notes. And conceptually flawed. Because when you talk about the corrupted state, when you argue for removing the black economy, we are trying to remove the entire higher denomination currencies. What Richard Nixon practiced in America, he withdrew all the higher denomination currencies, and the higher denomination currency in America is now $100. Why don't the government think of printing a smaller denomination currency instead of 2,000 rupee, and hence conceptually also it is flawed. Then coming to the implementation side, a lot of problems. And the implementation side is weakened so that the people are the sufferers, the continuous sufferers of this process. You know, I don't get into the issue of the fake currency, black money, terror financing, etc. But I would like to say that all these come under black economy. So the black economy is actually very powerful in the society. Addressing the black economy, demonetization is considered as a powerful tool. Okay, again, when you analyze the ethical or the logical justification of this ongoing process of demonetization, I would like to say that there are different schools of thought. One school argues that demonetization is a tool largely embedded in globalization. So this is actually practiced by a group of rulers or the government of India as part of globalization, and it has to be rejected. One school argues that, argues like this. Another school argues that, yeah, conceptually it is good, but on the implementation side, some problems. So if you are able to rectify the implementation problem, then one can accept the demonetization process. Even within the left, I found that there are two groups supporting the first view, one group supporting the first view and the second group supporting the second view. Okay, so my point is, the government could have made a lot of homework before implementing this demonetization. One, they could have thought of printing more 500 rupees notes and one additional small denomination of 200 rupees notes. That they didn't do. The second, they could have made at least all 2 lakh ATMs functional in the country. It is reported that almost, I don't know, it may be exaggerating, 1 lakh ATMs are not functioning properly. So the government could have at least, I'm not saying that, they could have set up more ATMs in rural areas. Actually, they could have gone for that also. Setting up of more ATMs, at least after the announcement of this demonetization process. Then, the government has not taken a number of institutions in faith. So my strong plea is that the central government could have, including RBI, could have taken the cooperative institutes, the charitable institutions, etc., in faith for implementing this demonetization process. They have totally neglected, ignored the cooperative institutes and charitable institutions. I don't repeat the point raised by other speakers. I have some, definitely I'm supporting some of the views expressed by them, and I have strong objections also to certain points. My conclusion is that, to discuss about the implementation, the impact of this demonetization on Indian economy, again, we have mixed feelings. You cannot say that this will produce bad results alone, and you cannot say that this will produce good results alone. Again, I find a combination of good and bad results, for which you have to wait for some period. A wait and see approach is required to analyze the impact of the demonetization on Indian economy. We are not sure about the amount of the black money you have in currency form. We don't have statistics regarding the exact fake currency. We don't have clear statistics about the Avala operations. Naturally, one has to wait for the clear statistics. The income tax, I hope that will bring out certain statistics relating to this after some 4 or 6 months. Then only you will be able to say that whether this process is a good attempt or bad attempt. But however, I have no hesitation to say that the sufferers of this process is 97% of the people, and the beneficiaries may be 3%. And the beneficiaries, I don't say that they are beneficiaries, they are the culprits. So for the 97% of the people who are coming, either working in the informal sector or unorganized sector, something like that, where the people are the clear sufferers of these problems. And for these 3%, benefit of the 3% population, we have taken a bad step, I will say that, bad implementation way of implementing a good process called demonetization in India. So I again blame the implementation aspect of this process. So I would like to, again, talking about the checking of black money or other issues, the government has not taken any serious steps. Somebody has mentioned about the P-notes. The P-notes has not been controlled by the government of India or any agencies responsible for that. It is still coming into the economy. Actually, we have to arrest the issues like P-notes, the issues like black money, which is held in the form of assets. We have not taken any sound steps to check these evils. And hence I would like to conclude that, though it is a bold step, it is a welcome step, the government has committed a lot of mistakes in the implementation side, and I hope that the negative impact of the demonetization will continue for at least 4, 6 or 8 months. It may even continue up to 1 year. So normally I believe that when demonetization is implemented, the negative impact period should be small. It should be maximum 3 to 5 months. There is no clear theory to state that. But my personal feeling, my understanding with the demonetization process forced me to tell that this should be contained, the negative impact should be contained within 3 to 5 months. Now, what is the story? The story tells us that this will go beyond 5 or 6 months, may go up to more than 1 year. If so, definitely our GDP will come down. And maybe to the extent of 1 to 2%, I'm not competent to again to say that the GDP will be contained by certain percent, but GDP will be contained. And hence my argument is that the implementation side has to be looked into seriously, and the government has to take a number of stringent measures to overcome this issue. With this, I conclude. Thank you for your patient listening.